rest in peace from the only name that matters, the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. I'm not scared of that. I'm glad definitively that it's just good to be alive. For make no mistake about it, somebody laid down last night and did not get up today. So the fact of the matter is that you got breath in your body. You know, that is enough reason, Tasha, for you to give God praise. I dare you, Coach Chris, to just tap your name and say, I thank God I'm still alive. If God then do another thing, but the fact that I'm still alive, so maybe that's powerful. Amen. Real quick, just before I dive into preaching, I want to thank God for Pastor Don doing an amazing job of leading us today. Let's give God another intercession for God. So praise to you. Bless God. Amen. For Dominique, Zach, Elder Kevin, Justin, Pete. Amen. For Mara, for the sister that he always does. And welcoming back with the sweet socks on. Brother Mincy, Bill, come on. Bless God. We love you. God is a healer. To my wife for providing such incredible news and information today. How many churches you know are able to put their residential prophet up so that he can be in a quiet place and pray for us and speak? Come on, bless God for vision, y'all. And as she declared, when you bless the prophet, you will receive a prophet's reward. I tell you, each three of y'all slip one hand up and declare, I'm waiting on my reward.
Yeah.
So we bless God, we bless God. But real quick, all leaders, all ministry leaders, don't forget our very important meeting this Saturday. This is the meeting where we're going to give our marching orders as we get ready to move into Greater Grace Church. Not the reason I don't know about you, but I thank God. The Lord has brought us a mighty, not better yet, the Lord has brought us all the way. I tell you, how high the leaders say all the way. So leaders will be right here from 10 to 12, and then we're going over to the facility. They should be finishing up. Renita, they should be finishing up. Brother Terry, somebody stop any day now. Any day now. Which means, y'all, Brother Paul Stokes, that we're going to have to stroke a check here real soon. Somebody stop stroke a check soon. Amen. So we got to get some chairs, y'all. Amen. So we not carrying these chairs. The Boys and Girls Club, who has been gracious enough for the last 7 months, another time to let us worship in here. The people next door have tolerated our noise. They tolerated our music. They tolerated my loud preaching for the last 7 months. So the least we can do is leave these chairs in here for the kids to have. Y'all ain't saying nothing in here. Let me say it this way. You don't want to carry anything old from your last season in the one talking right in here. It's in your new season. I need about three of y'all that's got some real faith. Prepare your neighbor's hand and say, neighbor, you pay for new wine in the old wine skin. I want to sit in the old chair. I want to preach on the old wine. It's got me from West London all the way to 700 Oak Grove, and I believe God ain't finished yet. I'm not going to make it and you ain't seen nothing. So today, we don't need some prayers. Lord's will, next week, we're going to raise money. We're going to raise money for the new sound system and the TV. Amen. Around from Virginia Beach to all of the
Come on, you guys.
know we told them initially they were 25. They went up to the turn and said they went up $4. They went up $4.
Ooh.
And the reason they went up $4 is we want to get, ladies, we want to get y'all the chairs that had the little compartment up under the chair. What you call it, the fancy thing up under. See, now you got chairs that don't have a compartment. And then you got chairs that have. And see, now I know you live in the age now, most folks don't do like me. You don't carry the Bible. You got the Bible on your phone. You got the Bible on your iPad, all that stuff. So the reason we don't go in the compartment up under the chair is I don't like women putting their pocketbooks on the floor.
Whether you like it or not, whether you want it.
service that was unplanned, unscripted, unexpected, and exactly what you need. Somebody got to shout, I got to see you in the ground. Now, how I got there was I was talking about Justin actually serving with Bishop William Luthien. So he, along with Minister Chris and Yolanda, but particularly Justin, they're going to install our new sound system into the Greater Grace Church. Let's give it up, God. Let's give it up, give it up. And the estimate that he gave, which would include everything potentially that we need, was about $9,000. Somebody shout $9,000. Look at your neighbor and say, that's on the low end. We're looking at having video screens, et cetera, so that you won't have any difficulty at all seeing the worship service. You won't have any difficulty at all being able to hear the worship service. You'll be able to hear it from throughout the entire building. Y'all, they just finished, Minister Lazarus, they just finished the stadium.